Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. What is absolute value? The absolute value of a number is its distance to zero on the number line, and the symbol used to denote absolute value is two vertical bars around a number. All right, so if I write this, see this two vertical bars around the number negative 4, we read this the absolute value of negative 4. And then this is what it means. You have a number line, and let's say here's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's where negative 4 would be, right? So what we're looking for is its distance to 0. So how many spaces is that? It's basically 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces. So then we say the absolute value of negative 4 is just the number 4 because it's 4 spaces from 0. So one thing you might note is absolute value cannot be negative. Never be negative because we're talking about distance and it doesn't make sense to talk about a negative distance. So here's four problems for you to try. See if you could figure out the absolute value of these four numbers. All right, so what's the first one? This would be the absolute value of negative 2. How far is negative 2 to 0 on the number line? Well, it's two spaces from 0. Absolute value of 3. How far away is 3 from 0? Three spaces. Now you could think how far away is 3 from 0 or how far is it to 0 from 3. It's the same thing. Absolute value of negative 1/2. All right. Well, that's only a half space away from 0 or half space to 0. And 5.6, the absolute value of 5.6. That's just 5.6 spaces away. So that's really all there is to it. Let's do one more. What about the absolute value of zero itself? Well, if you look at that, here's zero, right? All right, so how far away is zero from zero, or how far do I have to go? No place at all. So that as well is just zero. So notice in all of these answers, none of them are negative, but you can have the answer of zero. All right, so it's not that they're all positive, it's just that none of them could be negative. So that's it. That's all there is to the absolute value of a number. If you're trying to simplify an absolute value and there's an expression inside the absolute value, then first you need to simplify inside and then determine what the absolute value is. So let's look at this example. We've got the absolute value of 5 minus 2. Before you take the absolute value, you first have to just write down what the 5 minus 2 is. So I still write the absolute value symbols down, but 5 minus 2 is 3. And now I say, what's the absolute value of 3? That would be 3. Here's another example. We've got the absolute value of something that just isn't a single number. So what you're going to have to do is determine, first of all, what that number is. You have to simplify it. So in this case, it's a multiplication. So I have to do 3 times 7, which is 21. And now I take the absolute value of 21. So you don't figure out what the absolute value is until you get a single number inside of there. And so this is just the basics of absolute value, and it can get a lot more complicated than this, but we're just getting down to what does it mean? Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.